So good morning everyone. So we are the student of Christ University Banagada Road campus. So my name is Sakshi Nahata, and as a part of our CIA, Social Responsibility CIA, we have been working in Nagamma Foundation. So this foundation, it's mostly concerned with how to improve our soft skills, how to motivate people, and we are working under Jayaprakash sir, and he's truly inspired us. So we are going to present on the impact of positive attitude in our life. So what is basically positive attitude? Positive attitude helps to cope more easily with the daily efforts of life. It brings optimistic in your life and makes it easier to avoid worry and negative thinking. So why it's necessary to have positive attitude and positive thinking in our life? So if you are mainly positive, you will focus on good things and happy thoughts and successful outcomes. Otherwise, if you are mainly negative, you will focus on bad things. So now my friends will continue.
So even the darkest night will end and the sun will rise, by Victor Hugo. So the power of positive attitude basically exudes optimism in one's life. One doesn't have to live your life in a grandeur, in a lavish manner. One can find positivity and optimism in small gestures, in small aspects of life. And it's not about just putting on a happy face and being cheerful, but it's about making an impact. Either the impact should be like small or on a large scale. It should impact a person's life for his or her betterment. And basically, positive attitude, when speaking of positive attitude, there are a lot of motivational speakers like you have to go forward. There's no looking back, because in order to achieve your goals, in order to attain your objectives, you need to schedule your routine. You need to work on your inner self, rather than just a portrayal of what the societal norms need you to be. And in this cutthroat dog world, people always leave a part of themselves behind, and that's the true part they leave behind, because what they show to people is not their true self. It's just the portrayal of societal conventions that the societal conventions need you to be. And positivity makes your life more happier. As I said, small gestures make a big difference. And so people always have two types of goals in their life: short-term and long-term goals. So short-term goals basically, what are your plans for in a short period of time, upcoming events? And long-term basically thinking about a bigger picture. So Aditya will tell you about that.
Okay, so first I will clarify what you meant by short term and long term picture. Like short term can be on a weekly basis. Basically a short duration basis can be a weekly basis or a monthly basis. Like for example, you have to read a book. So if a short term goal can be that you have to read a book, you know, you have to read 3 books per month. So that can be your short term goal. Whereas your long term goal can be, you know, what you want to do be in life. Like for example, if you want to clear, for example, clearing your CA paper is a long term goal. Like it takes, you have to clear about 3 exams, and each exam is held in a duration between 6 to 8 months. So it takes about, because these papers are really tough, it takes about 3 to 4 years to clear these exams. So these can be your long term goals. So right now, I'm going to tell you tips to have a positive attitude so that you can always be surrounded by positive energy. So first thing you do is, when you get up, you should have a positive affirmation. For example, when you get up, you don't get up with a negative thought. You have to tell yourself that today is going to be a good day, and even if something happens which you haven't planned or something unexpected happens, you will take care of it. Secondly, focus on good things in your life. Like for example, you know, what people like, this is a very serious topic. People, what they do is that when they're not able to achieve something, or when they meet a lot of failures in their life, they resort to quitting. And you know, many of these quitting means committing suicide and all these things. But you know, these people don't realize one thing is that when you're doing these things, there are people in your life who care about you, like your family, your parents, your friends. So you know, if you ever reach a point where you ever think about taking such disastrous step, you should always think about especially of parents who've got you into this world. Then thirdly, find humor in bad situation. Obviously, you know, it's not possible that you're not going to be, you know, in a situation obviously life is full of ups and downs, and there are going to be lots of downs as well. But the thing is that you have to learn from those mistakes, and you have to make sure that these downs keep coming at you, so that you learn from them, and you know, the next time when something similar happens, you know how to tackle those situations. And then find positive friends, mentors and co-workers. Lastly, we are all the sunrise friends, so the biggest our biggest thing is that we need to find a good set of friends, and positive set of friends, of friends who you enjoy with. May not be the best type of friend, but the friends who actually show you the right way are the best kind of friends for you. You know, there's a saying that if everyone is doing the wrong, so it's better to go the right way than the wrong way. But if that path takes you to be alone, if you have to walk that path alone, then it's good, because it's going to be beneficial for you. Because if you think that your friends are not nice, because if you take in my age, a lot of even my classmates and all, they resort to things like, I don't want to say those things like this, but like things which are not good for the body as well, and they have influence on others as well. Because I remember in the first semester of college, most of the classmates in my class, they were very, you know, clean, and they came obviously everyone's come from good families, but they were not like this. But because of few students in the class, they all got influenced, and like many of them, because of all these things, of all these habits, they got suspended because they were not present in the class, the parents were called, and all these things were happening. And obviously when you're doing these things, you need to think about your parents also, because at the end of the day, it's going to affect them more than anyone else.
Hi, I'm Rohit, and first of all, I would like to thank Mr. Jayaprakash, because he has given a big opportunity to us. Like, from starting, I've been a very shy person, and I always have a stage fear. Like, even this kind of audience, I feel very stressful, like, what will I say, and how will I do? So, it's been a pleasure. And now, I would like to talk about the can-do attitude. Like, the first one is, you can do everything, but not all at once. Like, we always have an attitude that we'll cover this thing, we'll do that also, we'll achieve this. But by thinking this, we miss that we won't get a perfection in a particular thing. We should always focus on one thing that we like the most. And second is, can do everything if it's important enough for you to do. Like, you should always focus on the important things that you wish to pursue, not the things that you like when you don't have a eagerness to follow. Third is, you can do everything, but you may not be best at everything. Like, we always think that I'm best at this, even if a little bit, we always think that I can do this also, I can do that also, but this, we miss the main thing that we are best at. So we should do the thing which is very best for us. And the last is, you can do everything, but you need help. We always think that I am better myself. If I take help, I might have less knowledge than the other person. So we should not think like that. We should have a positive thinking towards other, and we should take help, because
it makes us better at the end of the day. And also, as my friend told about the goals, you should set a goal because it gives you direction and it also gives you a mental positivity and it helps you go throughout the life. And also, they said about short term and long term, we should also have a medium term goal, like in the middle of our life, what we want to do. Long term is a bigger picture we should consider, and we should also set smart goals. Like people have a thinking that we can achieve only the things by the hard work, but no one thinks that we can achieve the things by choosing the short path or the easier path. So this gives the this releases the stress in our life, and we should also think like that also.
I think the most important thing is that you should never let anyone tell you that you're not capable of doing anything, because if the day you start listening to that person is the day you lose in life. And like if you guys have heard of Jack Ma, he was the X1, he's the founder of Alibaba, which is the third largest e-commerce company in the world. And I don't know if you know this story, but he has a very motivational and inspiring story. So firstly, I want to say Jack Ma, he started Alibaba, which is the third largest e-commerce company in the world right now, and he's a billionaire, he's the richest man in China. And the funny thing about him is that he's not even a commerce student, or he's not even a business student. He did his graduation from English, not even honors, he did an English degree, and then he did BA degree if he wanted to teach and all. And I remember in one of his videos, he said that he was a master of failures. Like for example, when KFC first came to China, out of 10 people, 9 people got selected who went for the interview, and he was the only one who wasn't selected. And he went for the police constable interview as well, and 25 people had gone for the interview, and out of 25, only 24 got, all 24 got selected except for one, and that one person was Jack Ma. And when Jack Ma started Alibaba, it was back in 1993-1994. That time the internet was very new in China, and people did not believe in him. He had the investment of $1,000, that's it. And for the first 3 to 4 years, Alibaba did not make any returns. So all they were doing was they were just putting on money, but they were not actually getting return, and all they were facing was loss. And a lot of his colleagues left him. Even the person who actually co-founded Alibaba with him, even he lost the idea and hope that Alibaba would not survive, and nothing is going to happen, since all the money was getting drained. And but he believed in himself, and then he got the investors in America. And later is the story. Same with Elon Musk. Elon Musk, in one of his speeches, he told that he's basically, what people don't know about Elon Musk is that he's not actually an American, he's a South African. And when he was in his early 20s, he had come from America to South Africa, from South Africa to America. And when he had come with his brother, and he barely had some $100. So he had two options: either he had to rent an apartment for himself, or he had to rent an office. So what he did was he rented the office where he used to stay, and where he used to stay and work also. In that time, he also had a girlfriend who because he could not provide for her and he did not have money, she left him. And then again he believed himself, and later is the history. Elon Musk, as we all know, he's arguably the greatest visionary mankind has ever seen in the 21st century.
Okay,
over?
Thank you. So at the end, I'd like to conclude. In order to achieve our goal, we need to be specific. You should know the outcome of your goal, measurable. You should know when you will reach your goal, achievable. You should be able to achieve your goal, relevant. You should be relevant with what you are doing in order to achieve the goal, and time bound. We should always have a time bound to achieve our goal. So thank you.
Okay, thank you, one and all. So, you did your best. Okay, thank you very much. Claps for this. Good. Few sentences about your experience at Nagamma Foundation.